Now, next up, we have a speaker. Zinch, can you load up Joe's keynote? This guy is one of the most amazing men I know when it comes to the art of connecting with others. You will see pictures of him with Sir Richard Branson, Bill Clinton, Paula Abdul. He knows how to give value and get incredibly influential people to connect with him. He's personally fundraised over $1 million for Richard Branson's charity. In fact, he's the guy who got me on Branson's Island. It was a dream come true for me, and I owe that dream to Joe Polish. So Joe is also, not only is he well-connected, he's a master networker. He runs a group called the 25K Group. People pay him $25,000 to be part of this privileged group that comes together four times a year to meet and discuss how to elevate their business. I'm in that group. Paula Abdul is in that group. Best-selling authors like Brendan Burchard are in that group. And this is the kind of people that Joe hangs out with on a daily basis. Joe is also completely batshit crazy. He's like a total fucking fruitcake. I don't know how he does it. Like, sometimes I'm looking at him and his success and I'm like, why the fuck did God give you this? So, to answer that question, how can a guy who is perhaps certifiably insane and a bit of an asshole do so well? Let's see what Joe has to say. Give it up for Joe Polish.
Thank you. Full introduction. Okay, how y'all doing? Hanging in there? Okay, feeling pretty awesome? How many of you feel kind of lame right now? How many of you are just lame in general? Just not really. Okay, quick introduction. This will be the shortest speech I think I've ever given. Real quick background on me. Own a company called Piranha Marketing. Started out as a dead broke carpet cleaner. Out of desperation, I learned marketing because I needed to eat. I needed to survive. I learned how to use direct response. I turned this small carpet cleaning company around, started selling the same strategies to other carpet and upholstery cleaners on how to position yourself, because everything is really about positioning. And now we're the largest training organization in the world to the cleaning and restoration industry, people that do fires and floods and clean carpets and upholstery. And we have 5,800 companies all over the world in that industry, have my stuff licensed to multiple different niches, have the highest level mastermind group in the world for direct response marketers, people that in the info publishing business make 100 million, 200 million, 400 million a year, very high level people. Unbelievable stuff, but it all came out of marketing, and it all came out of the fact that I just simply needed to survive. And all of my success, if you want to call it that, is a byproduct of just intensive study in the area of direct response marketing. When God was doling out brains, 98% of my brains went on how to create a marketing campaign, the other 2% on how to run the rest of my life. So like Vishen was saying, I'm extraordinarily dysfunctional. Growing up, really shitty childhood. Later in my teens, drug addict. At my worst state, I weighed 105 pounds, 18 years old from smoking, freebasing cocaine for 3 months straight. I've had some real shitty, weird things in my life. But through personal development and just studying amazing people, developing relationships with amazing people, I've turned a lot of stuff around. So I'll try to impart a couple of things. Vishen wanted me to teach you guys how to actually, you know, meet cool people, that sort of stuff. Real quickly, I'll tell you, it is about positioning, okay? Marketing is what you do when you, well, selling is what you do when you're on the phone or face-to-face with somebody. Marketing is what you do to get someone on the phone or face-to-face with you, properly positioned so that they're pre-interested, pre-motivated, pre-qualified, and predisposed to give you money. Now, if you're not doing it for making money, you can do this with relationships. Like, we've actually raised over $3 million for Branson's charity at this point. I'm the largest fundraiser in the world for Virgin Unite. Raised a lot of money for Make-A-Wish Foundation. You can use everything I'm going to share with you for nonprofit stuff, for humanitarian causes. However, I'm really big on making money. The best way to help the poor is to not be one of them. And if you want to do some real, whenever you put the word social in front of anything, it sort of demeans it. The most social people in the world are entrepreneurs and capitalists that make shitloads of money, give people jobs, create value in the world. That's the way to live. That's what I believe in. And so basically, thank you. And I'll share with you a couple of things. I'm going to show you some marketing techniques because I want to give you a couple of strategies that if you just utilize these, they will be worth tens of thousands, potentially millions. I'm going to show you a strategy I've never showed to anyone before except in my 25K group, and it's totally badass. And I'm going to try to do this in a very short period of time, and I'm also going to show you, if we have room for questions at the end, You can maybe ask me some questions, because really what you learn in life is all about questions, and there's no such thing as a stupid question. There's only stupid people that ask questions. So, okay, having said that, 2 weeks ago we did one of my 25K groups. Richard Branson came to it. Here's something he said about me. I'm going to show you this because basically I'm a blatant name dropper. And, you know, when you have like Shamu the whale, like Branson saying good things about you, people actually think you're important. So I'll show you some of this propaganda.
Tim Mickelson, Richard. Life is about learning, and, you know, we're part of Joe's group and we're learning all the time ourselves. And just wondering, what are you learning in life at this point in time, and what have you learned from Joe Polish?
Well, Joe is doggedly determined. It never gives up, and actually has a big heart, cares about things, which we maybe wouldn't realize when you first met him. You'd think he's bloody good at the internet and pulling people together, but behind all that, anyway, has a very big heart.
He's actually lying. I do not have a big heart. I'm a very bad human being. But nonetheless, all right, so I'm going to talk about marketing multipliers. Using robotic marketing systems to create an ELF business, which stands for easy, lucrative, and fun. Where's Mark Schneider at? Okay, this dude right here, I've known him for about 15 years, met him from Joe Sugarman's house when we were doing a seminar together. He's the guy that created Blue Blocker sunglasses, Joe Sugarman. And Mark Schneider actually came up with the term ELF marketing. So publicly, I always credit people. One thing, if you want to get along in the world, don't steal shit from people. Always give people credit. It's just the right thing to do. There's so many people in personal development that take other people's ideas, never give them credit. I really don't want to give him credit because he doesn't deserve it. But he's the one that gave me the term ELF. And so, ELF marketing, easy, lucrative, and fun. I'm going to show you. I'm going to hammer through this. I'm going to talk fast, so listen fast. Here's some ELF marketing strategies. Okay, these are ways to position myself with clients, because everything you do in life is a sales job. Everything that comes out of your mouth is designed to either attract people or to repel people. And a lot of times, you actually do want to repel people. It's a good thing to do, to have a sales job where certain people don't come to you. So, here's an idea I gave to Dean Graziosi. Dean Graziosi now has about a $100 million a year company. You see this guy on infomercials all the time selling real estate stuff. He's the first New York Times best-selling author that has a free recorded message on the outside, on the cover of his book. So people can be in the bookstore, look at the book. There's a 24-hour free recorded message. They can call the free recorded message, hear a message from Dean about why they should buy the book, and actually capture their email in order to start marketing to them. How clever is that? If you have anything on your business cards, on any info products you have, on anything on the side of your vans, if you're in a service business, whatever, use free recorded messages. COA Networks is the favorite company that I actually use, but there's a lot of different companies that actually do that. So as an example of, you know, warning, reading this amazing book will change your life, call now to hear an important free recorded message from best-selling author, blah, blah, blah. And so on the other books that he has, there's drives to go to a website. You'll start seeing a lot of books doing this because I invented this process as it relates to books. And so a lot of people are starting to use this. Here's one of my clients, are Beachbody.com. The guys that do P90X, any of you do P90X, Insanity, any of these crazy workout videos? Do you guys know who I'm talking about, Tony Horton and stuff? Okay, they're a $400 million a year company right now. And they've sold 2 million units of P90X. The U.S. Army has started adopting their workouts. They're going to have on the outside of the box when you get P90X, you're going to hear a message from Tony Horton why you should get your lazy ass, you know, to start working out or whatever. And so my next goal is to get Jeff Bezos at Amazon to start doing it, and Tony Hsieh, my buddy at Zappos. Free recorded messages. I want to get millions of dollars of stuff sold simply from automated positioning techniques on boxes. I have the number one selling marketing program at Nightingale Conant since 2004, and right on the cover, we had a free recorded message sticker. It dropped refunds by 3% just by having a sticker cost nothing, and we can simply just get people void of sending someone a personal development program that holds them by the hand and runs their life for them. The best thing you can do is actually bond with them through theatrical means like free recorded messages. The reason I'm showing you this is if you want to meet people and get people to do business with you, the number one question in all consumers' minds is, who can I trust? Okay, who can I trust? And your job as a relationship builder, as a marketer, is to create trust and rapport. And rapport is trust with comfort. So not only do people trust you, but they feel comfortable with you. I actually learned that from my friend Neil Strauss's book, The Game, Penetrating the Secret Society of Pickup Artists. So basically, selling is like seduction. All of the stuff you do in advance is all the foreplay before you ask them to basically, you know, buy your stuff. So anyway, hopefully that makes sense. That's supposed to be sort of funny, but you guys have no sense of humor, and it's a deal. Like, no sense of humor fest? Come on, I have very low self-esteem. This is not helpful. Right. So anyway, that's just an example. So wanted to show you that. Now, here is an idea that this is killer. I'm going to make millions with this. And by the way, I've sold millions of dollars worth of info products to carpet and upholstery cleaners, and I teach people that sell a service that nobody wants to buy. If any of you here in the room sell anything even remotely more exciting than carpet cleaning, you can utilize these techniques. Does anyone in the room sell anything more exciting than carpet cleaning? Okay. Good. Okay. So here's the deal. Paula Abdul's a paying member of my 25K group, and she's in the group, and so I'm taking pictures of me. I've done a couple seminars with her, and I'm teaching her how to be an info marketer, and basically I have a testimonial from her. So we're going to send people a greeting card. You know, like these greeting cards they sell at Walmart or wherever, and it opens up. This is the new evolution of free recorded messages. You send them something, you open it up. I'm going to start having book authors. You're in a bookstore. Bookstores will hate it because it's going to be so noisy. Could you imagine that shit at a library? But anyway, so, they open the book and it starts talking to them, right? So I'm going to send high-level people this card from Paula Abdul. It's going to be pictures of her. They know her. They don't know me. So the inside of the card will look like this, right? It says, you're receiving this invitation. You must be a world-class entrepreneur because the criteria to get in my 25K group is make a net income of $1 million a year or more and have 3 years experience with direct marketing. I'm not trying to sell anyone here in my 25K group. Don't buy anything from me. If you want to buy anything, do the Silva method. Go to Lifebook. Don't buy shit from me. There's good stuff here. Seriously, do Lifebook. The deal is, so there's the card. So when they open the card, they hear this.
Hi, this is Paula Abdul. Joe Polish's 25K group has changed my life. I know that's a bold statement from someone who has had what most would consider a lifetime of success, but it's true. See, I was looking for my next reinvention and was seeking the best business insight to take my career to a new next level. And I knew with Joe's group, I would be surrounded by the brightest business minds in the world because it's designed that way. I knew I'd have Joe's cell phone and access to his network and Rolodex and all the resources through every 25K member. I talked to a few folks before joining, and they said if I didn't make my money back from the very first morning, that they'd be shocked. Well, they were right. In fact, I've made some multi-million dollar deals with several 25K members right now. This is such a special group because it's a close family of world-class talent driving and supporting each other to their best success. If Joe invites you, take the same advice I was given. Don't think about it. Just be daring and do it. If you want to know more about Joe Polish and my experience with Joe Polish, visit the website that's included with this card.
Okay, so is that cool or what? Now, you get someone saying good things about you, especially someone that's famous or whatever, very helpful, okay? And if you don't know anyone famous, that's okay. I mean, you know what a job of a marketer is? It's actually to manufacture credibility. Okay, there's all kinds of ways human beings try to make themselves look, important by cars, makeup, status symbols, clothing, whatever. So use the tools in your toolbox that you have, and as you continue to build value, how many of you have people in your life that would say nice things about you? Okay, good. How many of you don't know anyone that would say anything nice about you? Here's Mark, that is true. He's actually, there's a couple of you that I would agree with that. All right, so... Anyway, when they get the card, people are going to respond to that, right? That's pretty compelling. And then it's going to drive them to a website that's a personalized URL that has their name in it. Okay, so they're going to have a personal video from Paula saying, hey, that's how to get response. When everyone's putting all of their emphasis on internet marketing, there's less noise in people's mailboxes. I make more money with direct mail than internet marketing by far, because most people try to figure out how to do all this shit on the internet. I mean, send people a letter. Send them theater. Send them, like, crazy, outrageous stuff. Send them garden gnomes. I mean, whatever works. All right, so here's another thing that I'm doing. So at my last 25K meeting, I got pictures with everyone in the group, and so what is the Christmas gift I'm sending to them? They don't even know this shit. You're knowing what these people are being sent before I'm actually sending it to them. Got Telman up there who's in my group, so there's a picture of Telman with Richard Branson. Then we got John Carlton. He's in the group. We got Christy Frank from The Apprentice. We got Brendan Bouchard. So we're going to send them personal flip videos with pictures of them with Richard Branson. And right on the top of Richard Branson's head is a actual free recorded message. that talks about the 25K groups. And when they're doing a flip video, people are like, what's that picture? Oh, that's me with Richard Branson. Really? Where did you get that? Oh, that's from Joe Polish's 25K group. I've turned the damn gift into a sales pitch, okay? So you can do that at theflip.com. That shit, like, is insane. And so I hope you really, I mean, do you see the value in this? Seriously, I mean, I've got a lot of time to go deep with this, but you got to do this. This sort of stuff will make you a lot of money. It's not hard to do. I mean, you'd have to be brain dead not to do this if you actually have an application for it. See, I like to insult my crowd too. It really creates rapport and trust, and you know. But so anyway, for instance, whenever I carry flip videos everywhere, so whenever I can create value for someone, like Vishen asked me, how do you build rapport? I don't ask anyone to do anything for me if I can't create value for them first. So I always look for opportunities to help people. I do a lot of stuff with Virgin Unite. So I'm hanging out with. Do you know the artist Weiland? Okay, he's like the highest paid artist in the world, makes $100 million a year. He's the highest paid living artist right now, $100 million a year business. And so I'm over his, I'm having breakfast with him, and we're over his one of his galleries. He has 35 galleries in Laguna. I ask him, hey, can you donate some art to Branson's charity, Virgin Unite? So I have a flip video, boom. Here's a little video I shoot with Weiland for Richard Branson.
This is Joe Polish, and for everyone at Rock the Casbah, here to support the Virgin Unite Foundation and the Eve Branson Foundation, I'm here with the artist Weiland, and he's going to actually offer this as part of the auction, so I want you to take a look at this painting because you get to bid on it. So Weiland.
Okay, hey Richard, this is for your organization, Virgin Unite. Thank you for supporting their cause. This painting is called Storm, and it's kind of unique, but it's a big old schooner in a huge hurricane storm. One of my most popular paintings of all time. But anyway, it should raise over $1,000 for your great work you're doing out there with Virgin Unite. So I wish I could be there with you, but I'm there in spirit, and so is my art.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Weiland.
Okay.
So basically, I make Weiland feel really cool because he gets to offer a really awesome painting. It raises money for Virgin Unite, which we haven't auctioned it off yet. And I get both of them to actually think I'm kind of cool and important, which is funny because my goal is to create a lot of value for Weiland because he's never painted a piranha. He paints marine life and dolphins and, you know, nice fish. Screw that nonsense. I want a piranha. And so if I can get Weiland to paint me a piranha, that's fucking worth like $100,000 alone. That's killer. So anyway, all right, so that's why. So here, if you want my interview with Richard Branson, just to get, nothing is sold on this site. I paid Richard Branson a $200,000 check to speak at my event. He doesn't speak for money. He gives it to his foundation. He covers all of the frontline costs, so 100% of the money goes to the causes, which are environmental stuff, building entrepreneurism. So my interview is there, and it goes over how he spends his time, a whole hour interview with Richard Branson, really valuable, plus his presentation, plus my interview with Gene Owang. You can get that at my site, joepolish.com/Richard Branson. Okay, marketing multipliers. How can you incorporate a few of these techniques to multiply your results robotically? Now, say for instance, anything that you do, put a free recorded message together, put it on your business card, put it on your website, put it on letterhead, put it on postcards, put it on flip videos, put it on anything. Can all of you see applications from the things that I went through real quickly? I don't know if I just went through. Okay, how many of you are totally lost? Okay, no, okay. So, and if you do that, here's my Twitter page. Man, within 1 week of setting this up, I had someone call a free recorded message on my Twitter page and buy $3,000 worth of stuff. No one buys shit on Twitter because you got to get them off Twitter. Get them on a free recorded message, pitch them your stuff, talk about, and if you don't sell anything and you just want to meet girls, then put a free recorded message together why you're so freaking awesome and someone should go out with you, or a woman or whatever. Well, I thought that's a good idea, but none of you. Are you guys too tired or what's this? You know, I'm going to literally jump off the stage if I don't get over it. Okay, so anyway, free recorded message on my Twitter page, kind of funny. And yeah, let's see, what else? So be outrageous, do crazy stuff. You cannot bore people into liking you. I actually am introverted by nature. I don't like going to cocktail parties and places where I don't know people. It makes me very uncomfortable, but I learned how to put myself out there because you don't get checks if you don't, right? Okay, so you gotta put yourself out there. And you do that by asking questions. And tonight, okay, when everyone's hanging out in the pirate thing, if you're a little shy, how many of you would be offended if someone came up and introduced themselves to you? How many of you, no one? How many of you would love to meet someone new that you haven't met? Look around the room. People want to meet each other, okay? People, it's hard to build rapport. People think that, oh, what am I going to say? Go up to someone tonight and the Joe Polish question. If you could have any superpower whatsoever, what would it be and how would you use it? That'll keep you guys talking the rest of the night, even if you're drunk wearing pirate suits. Thank you. Okay, so just do stupid shit. You know, here's me wearing hats with Paula Abdul, Dr. Seuss, Mini Kiss on a donkey. I like riding donkeys, by the way. If you guys want to send me a donkey, that's cool. And, you know, here's me with Matt Mullenweg, founder of WordPress, 24 years old, $250 million a year company, guys that own Beachbody, Bill Clinton, I'm not a Democrat, by the way, Tony Hsieh, we got Dan Sullivan, Hugh Downs, Paula, we got Barry Diller, Jeff Bezos from, Amazon, Desmond Tutu, Bill Phillips, Joe Sugarman, you know, and interview people, like, that's how I've met so many people. I create interviews, ask them questions, people love to talk about themselves. Next week, 2 days ago, I interviewed, Tim Ferriss for his book, The 4-Hour Body. You can buy it on Amazon, some of my interviews on Amazon. Oh, I actually said I went and sell shit. Don't buy any of my shit, just the stuff that, you know, okay. So, and, I'm interviewing David Bach and Brian Tracy both next Tuesday for their new books. And so, but it's all through interviews, and you just start with anyone. And Tony.
Oh, it's Tony.
Hey, Joe. It's Jen.
And we are in Santa Monica right now on the Delivering Happiness bus tour. You see the bus behind us? DeliveringHappinessBus.com. About to do a book signing here. And just wanted to say hi to you and 25K you put together. So, hi Joe. Bye Joe.
Bye.
It's been real.
Oh,
we miss you dearly.
Sort of.
We miss you dearly, sort of. Okay, so I'm going to wrap up. Just real quick thing of what I did. So how do you create value with people? I'm on the plane with this guy, Ricky Wolman, and Citron Clothing. How many of you have heard of Citron Clothing? Sell it at Nordstrom's? Okay, he founded that company. And Nordstrom's, Macy's, a bunch of different boutique stores. And he was telling me about his clothing company. And I thought, how could I create value for this guy? Because I'm wired to do this stuff. On the plane, free Wi-Fi as a Christmas promotion, I send an email to Tony Hsieh, who owns Zappos, and his girlfriend Jen, who you saw there, and said, hey, I'm sitting next to the guy who has founded Citron Clothing. And maybe you can sell that at Zappos. While we're on the plane, Tony Hsieh emails back, literally in about 10 minutes, he emails back and puts him in touch with their actual purchasing person at Zappos. And Paula Abdul actually wears his clothing, and he has pictures with her. So when he goes back to L.A., which is where he lives, I'm going to set up lunch so he can go out with Paula and maybe get her to endorse it. And that was all by sitting there talking. Always think about how you can actually promote other people and help them. Was I trying to get anything about him? No, but now, since I'm saying this publicly, I hope he sends Jamie, my girlfriend, some free clothes, and then we're good, okay? So anyway, that's the deal. I gotta run. I will tell you, here's if you want to build rapport with people, be nice to the people you meet on the way up. They're the same people you meet on the way down. Your reputation is more important than anything. Don't hang out with scumbags. Don't shortchange people. Use hype in your marketing, but use it ethically. Hype used ethically is massive enthusiasm for what you sell. Hype used unethically is lying and bullshitting people. Always do it with integrity. Always create massive value. Send postcards to 10 people a day, handwritten, with a stamp, not a damn email. People are overwhelmed with email. It's ridiculous. Send 10 postcards a day for the next year. Your network will be 20 times what it is today. 10 postcards. You want a strategy? Simple, 10 postcards. Can everyone here send 10 postcards a day? No? Oh my God, okay, good. So, second, follow the referability habits by Dan Sullivan. Do what you say you're going to do, show up on time, finish what you start, and say please and thank you, okay? Do what you say you're going to do, show up on time, finish what you start, say please and thank you. If you do those things, you'll go very far. On behalf of myself, Vishen, I want to also acknowledge his whole team here because I do a lot of events. This stuff's hard work. Things get thrown off. I want to give it up for everyone and you guys. You've been sitting here long, you know. So that's it.
Give it up for Joe Polish.
Thank you. And
thank you.